That world-class cities are understanding that they have to do whatever they can to improve the quality of life in their cities. And so what we're looking to do is to make New York City the greatest, greenest big city in the world. A lot of the changes that you're seeing in New York City right now are a direct result of Mayor Bloomberg's Plan YC initiative, which is looking at all sorts of different ways in all sorts of city agencies to improve the way people live, work, and play.
Our agenda is to unclog our streets so that commerce doesn't get stifled. Our agenda is to clean the air and the water, use less energy. And we really try to focus on things that improve the quality of our lives today.
New York's approach is really fantastic because what it does is take this culture that we've created that really focuses on automobiles and shifts it a little bit to looking at people and actually moving people rather than moving automobiles.
And when you really start looking at streets in a kind of people-oriented way rather than a car-oriented way, it just starts to make sense. You start to realize the car, you know, in the most practical of terms, just doesn't make a lot of sense in a place like New York City.
One of the really fantastic things that New York is doing is really ramping up its bicycle infrastructure.
We've just rolled out 200 miles of on-street bike lanes in the last 3 years. So we now have over 450 miles of on-street bike lanes, which is creating a real network. And now we really actually have a cycling infrastructure.
You ride spots of New York City that you'd never ride before, you know, because you actually have a dedicated lane. Some of them are even like off traffic, so you're really protected.
We're building more robust bike facilities like this one, like the protected lanes on 8th and 9th Avenue. We're putting in more bike parking all around the city. We have the Bikes and Buildings Bill now, which allows tenants to request access from their landlords to commercial office buildings so they can have safe, secure bike parking. This is really for everyone. It's not just for Spandex or the Brave. This is for, you know, mom, dad, kids, everyone.
Hi, Josh. That's our bike coordinator.
Bus rapid transit is very important to the future of New York City, and I look at it as really a surface subway system. We put a new select bus service in the Bronx called the BX12, which is the major east-west connector in the northern part of the city. And we put in transit signal priority technology so that when buses hit a green light, the transponder would read that it was a bus there and give the bus the green light and hold the green light longer. And then we put in off-board fare collection so that people could pay for their fare before they got on the bus. You know, that delay when people are sort of going through their pockets and looking for change and trying to get their fare cards out, it's about a third of the delay in bus travel. Bus ridership went up 30%, bus speeds were improved by 20%, and in something that's really unheard of in my entire lifetime in New York City, some 98% of New Yorkers were very satisfied with the service. 356,000 pedestrians each and every day in Times Square. And so many of them were trading the safety of the sidewalk for dangerous streets because there just wasn't enough room. There was like a 10-to-1 ratio of pedestrians versus cars, and yet 90% of the space was allocated to cars.
They were very dysfunctional streets. They weren't really even working very well for motorists.
We came up with a plan that, while it was sort of counterintuitive to take Broadway out of the system and make the network work better, it actually worked better for traffic. It was a huge win for pedestrian space. We've created 1.8 acres of new pedestrian space there that's like 1.5 football fields. And it was a tremendous win for safety, some 63% reduction in injuries in the corridor.
And you go there now, and the first thing you notice is how quiet certain parts of Times Square are now. You can have a conversation and not have to shout above the din of traffic.
And then businesses really loved it. As you can imagine, the more foot traffic, the better it is for business. And so the way we've re-engineered our streets is not only to make them better from a safety perspective, better from a mobility perspective, but it's better business.
Well, since Plan YC was released in 07, traffic fatalities are down 20%. That's good. New York City's life expectancy has gone up 1 year and 7 months in the last 8 years. And part of that is reduced traffic deaths, a variety of other things as well.
It's taken them essentially 3 years to have a huge change in the way that their citizens commute, to the way that the people that live there actually enjoy their outdoor space. That's a big deal. 3 years in a planning time frame is a very short amount of time.
We're in a global economy and people can choose to locate their businesses and locate themselves anywhere. So we want to improve quality of life. We want to make our cities livable so that people choose to stay here and invest their capital here.
Once you realize that you can use your streets to improve the quality of life, the economics, and the environmental health of your city, I think that's a transformative moment. And so mayors around the world are looking at their streets differently, and you don't have to be a big city like New York to be able to make important changes that matter to millions of people each and every day.